Good morning to one and all. I am Dr. Swapna from Department of Conservative Dentistry and Endodontics. As a part of e-learning program, today we are going to discuss about dental cements. There exist different types of dental cements available in the market. So this is a very huge topic to be discussed. So as a part of that, we are going to deal this topic in different parts. Mainly today the topic of discussion was part one, introduction, classification and silicate cements. Coming to the introduction, the term cement in general applies to a material that can be used to loot things together. Coming to the definition, dental cements are generally inorganic, non-metallic substances that harden to act as a base or as a liner or a restrictive material, or otherwise it can act as an adhesive to bind devices or processes to the tooth structure. Every cement must be assessed for its biocompatibility, safety and effectiveness. Ideally, a cement does not cause damage to a tooth structure, mainly the pulp, and to have certain suitable physical properties and provide passive or active properties. Many cements are supplied as a powder and as a liquid or in a two-paste combination, so that when you mix both the things, it starts particular chemical reaction. Generally, the liquids will act as acids that are proton donors, and powders mainly are basic in nature. They mainly set via acid-base reactions. Many types of cements are used in dentistry which are available in the market. For easy understanding, all the cements are discussed under four categories. Mainly the cements for restorative purpose, cements for looting, cements for pulp protection and cements used in endodontic specialty. Before going in detail about different types of cements, let's have a look on general properties of the cement. The first property of the cements are working time. It is the time that elapses from the start of the mix till the material can be placed in the prepared tooth. Cements should have an adequate working time in order to achieve proper uniform mix. Generally, the working time of many cements ranges from 2 to 5 minutes. Next property was setting time. It is nothing but the time that elapses from the starting of the mix until the material hardens. It generally ranges from 2.5 to 8 minutes. But for light curing resin cements, material sets only on command set, that is when the light curing is done, the cements will be setting. Next was the film thickness and consistency. Generally, the looting cements exhibit very low viscosity when mixed in order to flow under when the pressure is applied. Ideally, the film thickness is to be less than 25 microns. The consistency of a restorative cement is to be thick and plastic enough for easy handling. Coming to the solubility, it should be near to very low and none, but most of the cements exhibit various degree of solubility. Water-based cements are more soluble than oil-based cement. Ideally, cements should be very less soluble in the oral fluids. Next was your compressive strength. Generally, all the cements should exhibit some amount of compressive strength. At least a minimum of 24-hour compressive strength should be 70 megapascals. Modulus of elasticity. Modulus of elasticity is to be as close as to the dentin. And biological properties. It should be very non-irritating to the pulp, but generally acid-based cements are more irritating when at the time of placement because of their lower pH. And removal of excess cement should be easy and it should have an higher retention. These are the general properties of any cement which you are going to use in the dentistry. Mainly, this flowchart explains about the water-settable cements which showing acid-base reaction. These are the five basic cements which sets by acid-base reaction, that is silicate cement, zinc phosphate cements, zinc oxide eugenol cement, zinc polycarboxylate cement and glass ionoma cement. Mainly, the silicate cements are the oldest cements. The main ingredient in the powder and liquid are in silicate cements. Powder contains fluoride containing aluminosilicate glass, whereas In that, the liquid was your phosphoric acid. Whereas in case of your zinc phosphate, the main ingredient of your powder was zinc oxide and your liquid was phosphoric acid. And coming to the zinc oxide, eugenol, powder contains zinc oxide and liquid contains your eugenol, that is nothing but your clove oil. Whereas in case of your zinc polycarboxylate cement, the powder contains zinc oxide, whereas the liquid was polyacrylic acid. In case of your glassinomer cement, the powder mainly consists of fluoride containing aluminosilicate glass and the liquid contains polyacrylic acid. Coming to the classifications of cements, there exist different types of classifications. Mainly, this was the Skinner's classification based upon their reaction of your setting. That is, first one was your zinc phosphate cement. The principal uses of your zinc phosphate cement is mainly used as an eluting agent and as an insulate thermal insulating basis. The reaction type was acid-based reaction. And next one was your zinc oxide eugenol cement. It mainly used as an temporary intermediate eluting and restorative material. And the secondary use was your mainly used in root canal sealers and also periodontal and surgical dressings. Reaction type was acid-based reaction. Next one was your zinc polycarboxylate cement, mainly used as an eluting agent, and type of reaction is acid-based reaction. Silicate cements mainly used as an anterior filling materials, whereas glassinomer cement is a fluoride releasing cement and mainly it is used in anterior restorations, pit and fissure sealants, and also it is used as an cavity liners and luting agents, and it also sets by acid-based reaction. Next comes your resin modified GIC, mainly used in case of your core buildups and conservative posterior restorations, sets mainly by light or chemically activated polymerization and acid-based reaction. Next is your resin cements, mainly used as in luting agents and sets by light or chemically activated polymerization. Calcium hydroxide cement is mainly used as an intracanal medicament or pulp capping agents. And next classification was your Craig's classification. Craig's generally classified all the cements into three subcategories, that is water-based cements, oil-based cements, and resin-based cement. Water-based cements mainly set by acid-based reaction. Under this are your GICs, resin-modified GICs, zinc phosphate, and zinc polycarboxylate. Oil-based cements is based upon the presence or absence of your eugenol. It contains zinc oxide eugenol and non-eugenol cements. And resin-based cements is nothing but your composite resins. Next classification was O'Brien's classification. It is mainly based upon your matrix type. They are subdivided into phosphate-based cements. Under that comes your zinc phosphate and zinc silicophosphate. Phenolate-based cements, that is your zinc oxide eugenol and calcium hydroxide. Polycarboxylate cements, mainly the zinc polycarboxylate and glassinomer cements. And resin cements, that is your polymethyl methacrylate and dimethyl methacrylate, both filled and unfilled resins. Next classification is by ADA specification. Type 1 is a fine grain for cementation or luting purpose. Type 2 is mainly medium grain for your bases and your orthodontic purpose. And next classification was your Donovan's classification. It's mainly divided into conventional cements and contemporary cements. Conventional cements are mainly zinc phosphate, zinc oxide eugenol, zinc polycarboxylate and glassinomer, whereas the contemporary cements are your resin modified GICs and resin cements. When coming to the applications of your dental cements, that is mainly the uses of your dental cements, they are broadly used as your luting agents, either it can be temporary luting or permanent luting, pulp protection or a cavity sealer, maybe it can be used as a cavity varnish, liners and bases, fillings, mainly your temporary filling or your permanent filling. Others was like it can be used as an intracanal medicament and root canal sealers, mainly your calcium hydroxide cements was used, and also as an bite registration material. Coming to the silicate cements are the one of the oldest cements used in the dentistry. They are the direct tooth colored materials. It was first introduced by Felcher in 1873. The ADA specification number was 96, and mainly it is available in powder and liquid form. Coming to the composition of your silicate cements, powder mainly consists of your silicon dioxide, aluminium trioxide, sodium, calcium and aluminium fluorides. Mainly these fluorides act as fluxes and also they aid in anti-karyogenic properties, and also they have your coloring agents. And liquid mainly consists of 35-50% phosphoric acid and sodium and aluminium phosphates. Mainly the sodium and aluminium phosphates act as a buffer. Next is setting reaction. Mainly it sets by acid-base reaction, when the powder attacked by the liquid releases calcium, aluminium and fluoride ions. These metal ions precipitates as the phosphate forms a continuous matrix, whereas fluoride ions do not take part in the reaction and presents as the free ions in the matrix, which will further aid in anti-karyogenic property of this particular cement. Whereas the set structure of this set cement consists of phosphate matrix containing unreacted powder particles coated with silica gel. Coming to the in-detail properties of your silicate cement, first is the anti-karyogenicity. Anti-karyogenicity is nothing but the material that is having, that aids in caries inhibition. Anti-karyogenicity, it contains large amount of fluoride ions, makes the cement highly anti-karyogenic in nature. Coming to the biocompatibility, as the pH of the cement is as low as 3, hence it is severely pulpal irritant. Solubility, it's highly soluble in saliva and makes this cement exhibits a less micro leakage. Disintegration, there is a gross loss of material and which is very obvious in case of silicate cements, leading to its surface roughness and leads to its leakage. Whereas is the aesthetics, the optical properties are good and the silicates are very much transparent, thus making it in a good aesthetic material, that is it making in a tooth colored restorative material, and mainly the adhesion was purely mechanical. Coming to the advantages, it's highly aesthetic in nature because of its transparency, and it is anti-karyogenic in nature because of its high fluoride release content. Whereas the disadvantages was, due to its high solubility, it is easily attacked by the oral fluids, resulting in a rough surface which can be easily taking the stains, leading to the discoloration in a future. And it has very less service life and it's highly pulpal irritant. So due to its more disadvantages, it is not in use nowadays, but understanding its composition and properties of this helps in understanding our contemporary cements much better. Thank you.